welcome to the Candlelight Processional. Tonight's presentation is under the baton of conductor Dr. John B. Sinclair. Dr. Sinclair is the conductor and artistic director of the Bach Festival Society of Winter Park. He is also the chair and John M. Tiedtke Professor of Music at Rollins College.
Thank you.
welcome to the stage the Voices of Liberty and the EPCOT Candlelight Processional.
Gentlemen, magnificent display.
everyone, please welcome this evening's special guest narrator, Auli'i Cravalho.
Aloha! Excuse me? Aloha! There it is. Good evening, everyone, and welcome. I'm not sure if you know, but Walt Disney began the tradition of the Candlelight Processional at Disneyland over 60 years ago. This year, Walt Disney World celebrates 50 years of magic here in Florida. And in that time, literally millions of guests have enjoyed the Christmas story, the traditional carols, and especially the glorious music of the holiday season. To continue this marvelous heritage, I invite you to sit back and enjoy our magnificent orchestra and awesome singers. Now let us begin. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin who was betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus." In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. And all went, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in the same region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord."
Oh,
There was the angel, a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards all." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them.
Yeah.
Now, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose in the east and have come to worship him." And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. That they had seen went before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Thank you.
The story of the birth of Christ has been told and retold for over 2,000 years. About 200 years ago, in a small church in Austria, on a quiet winter's day, the organist Franz came to the young priest Joseph Moore and said, "Father Joseph, the church organ is broken and we will have no music for the Christmas Eve service." Later in the day, as Joseph made his rounds, he visited a home where a baby had just been born, and he thought about the birth of the baby Jesus. Inspired by the miracle of life and love, comforted by the peace that fell over the town, he rushed back to the church and wrote a poem. Joseph said to Franz, "We may not have the organ, but if you can play the guitar, then maybe we could have a new song instead," Franz said. "Father, I only know three chords." "Then let's make a song with three chords." Well, Franz used what he knew and slowly and carefully pulled forth a tender melody from those three chords. And lo and behold, he had composed the most beautiful and beloved of all of the Christmas carols. It is a gift bestowed upon us all during this special time of year. Tonight, people around the world mark this joyful season with heartfelt sentiment. As we each treasure our unique holiday traditions of family, faith, and culture, let us join together in celebrating the birth of the blessed babe in the manger and rejoice in the universal message of peace on earth and goodwill toward all. Joy to the world.
Thank you.
unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Thank you so very much. I have sincerely enjoyed being here with you, and I hope you have enjoyed this candlelight processional. As we say in Hawaii, mele kaliki maka and hauoli maka hiki ho, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. However you celebrate during this time of year, may you and yours find the love and joy and peace of this holiday season.
Christmas, everyone. We'd like to take a moment to extend our sincere thanks to our cast choir, orchestra, conductor, the Voices of Liberty, and to tonight's guest narrator, Auli'i Cravalho, as well as all of you. How wonderful it is to come together and celebrate the sentiments of the season. We hope you enjoy the rest of your night at the EPCOT International Festival of the Holidays, presented by AdventHealth.
Get the exact same theme park tickets for less, no catch, at UndercoverTourist.com.